Hey, Frontline fans, welcome back to Comic Frontline and fans. It's Spider Slayers Hall 6.1. That's right, guys. Now, these 0.1 comic book hauls are usually for special occasions. That's right. And today is the first Saturday in May. What does that mean? Free comic book day. That's right, guys. The hugest day of the year for comic book fans because it's like a flipping holiday. I mean, different stores have different sales. They're giving away free comic books. There's mascots or comic book characters flying around. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff going on. And today on Comic Frontline, I wanted to show you the comic books that I purchased. And I'll show you here. This is the books. And I also got a mystery box. My comic book store does this on Free Comic Book Day, where they do these types of mystery boxes. And there's all kinds of goodies inside. And I'm really excited for it. So first things first, let's show the comic books what I got. Then we'll do the mystery unboxing. Yes. All right. So here we go. First things first, stuff in the bag. Now, in order to get my 10 free comic books, I have to spend at least $20. So that's what I did. I always spent 20. In fact, I spent like 35 because, you know, can't just go in there spending the bare minimum. So first thing I wound up getting is I'll show you the free comic books that I wound up getting. So first things first was the free comic book Suicide Squad, the reprints. I don't know why I got it. It was for free. I already have the first one, but hey, what the hell? Why not catch up and see what the characters are about? The next one I wound up getting was the One Punch Man Free Comic Book Day Edition. Never read One Punch Man, but I looked inside the actual interior art on this one, and it looked pretty good. I like seeing manga in kind of like a comic book form, like in larger print form. I think it's really cool, and I might actually do a review on this on Manga Masterpiece. Excuse me, can't talk. So that's really cool. All right, next I wound up getting this book by Grant Morrison, this free comic book day book. It's called Avatar X. Looks different. I don't know what to expect from it, but definitely looking forward to reading that. There's some of the artwork inside. Definitely a futuristic sci-fi book. I get to see some guy in some tube. And yeah, but I'm curious to see what this book is about. It's definitely different, and you can't beat it for free. So Avatar X. All right, next I wound up getting from IDW, which is ROM. Which is what, Ron the Space Knight, based off of from Marvel, and it's on IDW. Not sure why this is here, but nevertheless, though, I wanted to actually read this and see what this story is actually about. So I'm excited about this one. This one looks pretty cool. There's some cool interior artwork in here. And so, yeah, this is good stuff. All right, next, it seems like they always have a free comic book day, Tick Comic. And I had to pick this one up. So, and here you get to see the Tick, and he looks like he's being judged, and it's called New Stories, and he's being judged by other colored Ticks, and there's a whole bunch of Ticks in the background. I don't know, but this is you know, Tick is always a hysterical book. Here, there, you got author. I love this series overall. Like, I love Tick, and I love the Fox series also. So cool stuff here, and this is Tick. Alright, next I got for my son, I got him Pokemon Pocket Comics. You know, he's a huge Pokemon fan, so I decided to get this for him. Can't beat it, you know. I guess it gives you a little bit description of the different types of Pokemon that's inside. So he'll like this. And then next I wound up getting Free Comic Book Day Sonic Sampler. Again, he likes Sonic as well. And then on the back side of this, you wind up getting Sonic number 1 Mega Drive. So that's neat too. And it shows you, I guess, a preview, and it's coming in summer of 2016. So that's pretty neat. You open it up and you kind of get this inside, this like poster. So that's cool too. So yeah, if you're a Sonic fan, I think this would be cool for you. And then next I got another video game free comic book day, and this is Street Fighter V. So that's neat too. I mean, I don't play that many video games anymore, but I grew up to Street Fighter, and having a comic book on this why not? I mean, they have the current Street Fighter series from IDW right now. And this one's looks like it's, I guess it says Capcom on there from who makes it. So that's pretty cool as well. Look at interior artwork in here. Looks pretty gorgeous. I'm not going to lie. It's nice looking artwork. Reminds me almost like anime. So that's really nice. All right. Next, we wind up getting DC Superhero Girls. My daughter's a huge fan of this. She has the Wonder Woman doll. She asked for all the other dolls for her birthday. And these are the dolls in the back. And I'm glad to see this getting exposure, getting its kind of like its own comic. And they show the actual short TV cartoons on Teen Titans between the commercials. So I think that's pretty cool, too. I think this is good for young female readers getting to something that they want to get their hands on. So this is DC Superhero Girls. Next, I got the Marvel Captain America Free Comic Book Day. This is a cool cover as you get to see what looks like Hydra agents in Captain America's shield. Maybe we'll see how he actually got this particular shield, because in the most recent stories, he just got his suit back and he got this shield. Well, how did he get it? We know how he came back, but we don't know how he actually got this new shield and why he went this way. So I don't know. But this is Captain America. I think it's written by Nick Spencer. And then, of course, you can't beat the Civil War II. This is the big one of them all for Free Comic Book Day from Marvel, as it's kicking off the Civil War II event. Has Thanos on the cover, Captain Marvel, and War Machine. So definitely anxious of reading this one. Jay here on Comic Frontline will be doing a review on this book. So if you guys want to see an individual review, check out the review from Jay Philly Superman. All right, now to the stuff. All right, so I decided to buy this. I didn't buy it when it first came out. This is Harley Quinn Suicide Squad April Fool's special. It was on the rack still, and I love Jim Lee's artwork. And I didn't realize Jim Lee did this entire issue. So when I saw that he did the interior artwork in it, I was like, wow, I really must pick this up, because I just love his artwork. He draws Harley absolutely beautiful. The attention to detail to the characters that he draws is absolutely gorgeous. So I had to pick this up. I just decided to say, hey, why not? What the hell? And so I was like, that's fine. So Harley Quinn's Suicide Squad April Fool's special. And then the next thing I wound up getting for $15, this was on sale as well. This was The Amazing Spider-Man. We can see the complete Ben Reilly epic, book two. So this covers a whole bunch of different individual stories with Ben Reilly. And I couldn't be more excited to find this. Whenever I can find a good Amazing Spider-Man trade that I don't have, or certain issues I don't have that complete the series in my comics for super cheap, this was my pickup of the day right here. So I'm totally excited about this. This book retails for $40, and I got it for $15. So really excited about this one. God, yes. All right. Now, you're probably wondering what's inside the box. Well, this is my comic book store's box, and they do it every year. So we're going to open it up and find out right now. So, again, I'm not going to look inside. I'm going to keep it a mystery, and we're going to unbox it together. And it could be crap. It could be good stuff. My mystery boxes at my comic store tend to be pretty good. I have not been really let down. I think there's been one time where I was a little bit let down with it. So here is the box. You can see that I have opened it. I have not looked inside. I'm going to keep my eyes up in the sky or looking at the screen, and we're going to show it together. So here we go. Eyes are closed. And the first thing I wound up picking up is this. It's a book. I'm not sure what it is. And it is a blank thing. It's not a book. It's a poster. Uh-oh. Here we go. Poster time. Uh-oh. You ready for this? Oh, my God. How fitting is this for Mike Spider Slayer to get this poster right now? Look at that. Miles Morales. Spider-Man. Issue number one, I think it is. Oh my god, that is so fucking cool. Excuse the ball, the word. But I am totally excited about that poster. Where am I going to put it? I got no more room for stuff. Oh my god, I'm so pissed that I can't put that up. Okay, cool poster. So far, we're 1-for-1. Let's see what we got now. Alright. Oh, please be good. Is it some kind of pop figure? What is it, everybody? It's something. It's a box. Oh, okay. It is a Guardians of the Galaxy Dorbs vinyl collection, and it's Ronin. That is cool. I'm totally happy with that. Yes. Okay. Totally excited about that. We're 2-for-2. All right. Next. Okay. This one feels like a pop figure. The box is big. Has to be a pop. It feels like it. This is the part of the front. This is the back. Oh, please don't be something dumb. What the hell is this? Hunger Games? Katniss, the Girl of Fire. Okay, so it's from the Hunger Games. I guess that's pretty cool if you're a Hunger Games fan. Technically, for me, I'm not a huge Hunger Games fan. But if you are, this is pretty cool. Can't complain so far. 2-for-3. All right. Ready. So I paid $15 for this mystery box. All right, next thing. It's a pin. Poe Dameron. Hell yeah. That's a win. Can't complain about that. All right, next. It's got to be like some candy or something. What is this? It's a Star Wars Micro Machines. So we get a mystery within the mystery. What do we get? Let's open it up and find out. All right, here we go. And it is, whoa, pretty badass right here. TIE Fighter. That's pretty cool. Can't complain about that. That's a win, too. All right, so far we're doing pretty good with this deal. All right, this is a book. Manga? I don't know. Trade something? Cobra Wars. Mr. Brant Fowler from Comic Frontline is a huge star G.I. Joe fan. He would love this. This is an actual novel. It's a book. So, Tales from the Cobra Wars. Yeah, retails for $10. Hey, that alone is worth the value, right? That's cool. All right, that's a win, too. All right. There's one more thing in here, I think. Yep, that's it. So this is the last thing. It's a, I don't know what the hell this is. Something's wrapped around it. It's a book also. What the fuck is this? Kiki's Delivery Service. So this is manga, I guess. Yeah, right? Yeah, and it's weird. It's got like an actual cover on it. Weird. But this is good for a manga masterpiece. Kiki's Delivery Service. It sounds like some kind of, like, I don't know, escort service, the way it is. But, okay, that's cool, I guess. And same thing, retails for $10. So, hey, you win some, you lose some. But nevertheless, it was a lot of fun doing it, and I love doing videos like this. So, there you have it, guys. There is the Free Comic Book Day Haul 2017. Hopefully you enjoyed it as much as I have bringing it to you. And fans, in the comments below, tell me what your comic book store had for your Free Comic Book Day sales. And did you have special music? Did you have characters? What books you picked up? Did you have mystery boxes? Show me all that stuff, and I'd love to hear it. So again, guys, thank you for watching Comic Frontline. Don't forget to watch us or to like us on Facebook. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter. Don't forget to watch our live show each and every Tuesday night, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where we talk about our top five and our comic news of the week. You can listen to us on SoundCloud, Stitcher, iTunes. We're all over the place. So again, guys, thank you for watching. And this is Mike Spider Slayer signing off. Take care, guys. See you soon. Bye.